Just 1 year after selecting Connor Bedard with the first overall pick, Kyle Davidson will now have to decide who to take with the second overall pick come June. Not a bad position to be in. And here to help us look at some of those top prospects and the direction this rebuild could go, our friend of the show, Jay Zawaski from CHGO. Jay, thank you so much for joining us. Last year, we all knew who the pick was going to be, and now Kyle Davidson, just joking, saying, I'm not going to tell you who the pick's going to be. If you're Kyle Davidson, who are you targeting, and what direction should they go?
Well, there's two names to keep an eye on for sure, and I appreciate you guys having me on. Always do. Thank you. There's a defenseman from Michigan State, Artem Levchinov, if the Hawks are looking to go defensive. And if you look at what they have in the system so far, you can look at a lot of prospects ready to go on the blue line, right? You've got Kevin Korchinski already here, Alex Vlasic already here. You saw Ethan Del Mastro last year. There's Nolan Allen. There's others on the way. But the opportunity to draft a guy that could be a legitimate number one defenseman and a guy that can play on the right side, which has suddenly become a bit of a luxury in the NHL, could be very tempting for Kyle Davidson. But for me, if I'm doing it, I'm taking it forward to play with Connor Bedard for the next decade plus. And that's Ivan Demidov, who plays in Russia right now. He's got 1 year left on his contract in Russia, so he'll play next season regardless in Russia, no matter who drafts him. But this is the opportunity the Hawks have to take somebody who can take some of the offensive scoring pressure off of Connor Bedard, someone who could score 40, maybe 50 goals in the NHL. And the way Kyle Davidson has spoken this offseason about his plans of improving the team, it's unlikely the Hawks will be picking this high in the draft again for quite a while. So you have an opportunity to bring in a dynamic scorer to be that lifetime partner, I guess you could say, of Connor Bedard. And that's really tempting. And that's what I'm doing. I'm taking Demidov if I'm making that pick.
I was going to ask you earlier today, as I was thinking about questions, I was going, man, ask Jay, what does he think that Kyle Davidson's going to do with Lukas Reichel? And does he see him as one of the young core pieces moving forward? Then today we see the contract extension. What was your take on Lukas Reichel and how he performed this past season? And what do you see for him as going into next year?
Well, there's no doubt that this year was a disappointment for Lukas Reichel. I think the way he ended the prior season, he finished very, very strong. And the expectation was, okay, opening day of 2023-24, he's going to become one of the team's most dependable scorers. You can kind of check that box and you know that that's already done. That's not how it went this year. He really, really struggled. Luke Richardson tried pretty much everything to get him going, and they finally said, well, we don't really have any other choice but to send you down to Rockford. Got his game back in order down in Rockford, came back up and played pretty well, and it was really great to see him score in the last game of the year. I think that was a huge moment for him. Kind of a monkey off the back, performed well in Rockford's brief playoff stint. And this deal, you know, 2 years, $1.2 million per year, that's really low money for the Hawks. And I think what they're hoping for is by the end of this year, or even in the middle of this year, they look at that $1.2 million as an absolute bargain. And he starts to look like the guy he looked like towards the end of this year because he's got all the skill. Lukas Reichel has to figure out is what it's going to take for him to become an everyday contributor at the NHL level. And he seems like after finally that demotion to Rockford, he got the message. He heard what Luke Richardson was telling him and he responded and did the things he was asked to do. And lo and behold, when you do that, you get results. And he did start to get recording some points and some goals. So now hopefully he's got a nice strong off season, comes in ready to go and really takes advantage of this opportunity, because if he doesn't perform for these 2 years, his days in Chicago are probably numbered.
It's crazy too, K-Shark. He's only 21 years old. He's still young and with a lot of room to grow. Go ahead, K-Shark.
Yeah, Connor Bedard, obviously, Jay, has been such a joy to watch this season. He has been the, you know, you would say the lone bright spot of this team. And Kyle Davidson said after, you know, today's draft lottery, yes, it was uncomfortable this season at times, but that's why we're in the position now to have that second overall pick. So when you're thinking expectations and direction of a rebuild, and if fans are starting to get, I don't know, maybe a little impatient because they're like, okay, we have this superstar, how long is this really going to take before this Hawks team are serious competitors? In your mind, how is the direction? Do you have faith that it's headed in the right direction?
I have no doubt that it's headed in the right direction. It's a matter of kind of when, not if. I really like what they've done prospect-wise. We saw, you know, Frank Nazar come up and score in his first game And Landon Slager comes from Notre Dame, jumps right in the lineup, doesn't miss a beat. They've got Oliver Moore in the minors, and that's just up front, plus whoever they draft this year. The future is very bright. Now, what's going to be interesting to me is how serious is Davidson this summer about improving the team? Because he said, this can't happen again. We can't finish this low in the standings again. It's inexcusable. It's got to get better. He put it on himself to make the team better. I think indirectly, he was putting on Luke Richardson to make the team better too. So I think he's going to be active this summer. I think he's going to bring in some players and maybe not some superstar, you know, break the bank, massive contract kind of guys. But I could definitely see two or three guys brought in that are legitimate in or near their prime NHL players to make this roster stronger and make this roster better. And if you have Taylor Hall come back healthy, and all reports are that he's almost ready to go, a full season of Andreas Athanasiou, improvement from Reichel, improvement from Bedard, improvement from Korchinski, you start to add all these things up, and you can really see how bright this team's future is, and it may not be as far away as people think. Now, in terms of contending for a Stanley Cup, that's still probably 3-4 years away. But I think if things go the way they want it to go this year, and the offseason is the way they want it to go this year, they will be in the playoff conversation. They might not make the playoffs, but they'll be playing meaningful games towards the end of the season. And to me, that would be, you know, a decent enough improvement for this team, because you need these guys, these young players, to play in games that matter if you really want to develop them correctly.
Absolutely. All I had to hear was meaningful games in the near future. Jay, thank you so much for joining us tonight on GN Sports. We'll talk to you soon.
Anytime. Thank you.